Oxidative stress comes from reactive oxygen species, and these are highly reactive molecules that can damage different parts of the cell. They can damage the lipids, the proteins. They can cause a lot of damage. And if there's too much damage that's accumulated within the cell will die, and antioxidants mop up these reactive oxygen species and essentially act as a sponge and prevent this damage from occurring. So when a cancer cell is in a stressful environment such as the blood or visceral organs, it is experiencing high levels of oxidative stress because of the high concentration of these reactive oxygen species within the cell. And what that antioxidant does is essentially provide a sort of way of mopping up these reactive oxygen species and reducing the amount of damage, and therefore allowing more cells to survive. It's true that antioxidants prevent initiation of cancer and prevent the initial, probably the initial formation of the tumor. But once the tumor is established, just like other cells in the body, it's protected by antioxidants because it will experience oxidative stress in the same way as normal cells will. So yes, while antioxidants are protective in terms of getting new tumors and initiating cancer, they're actually probably detrimental at very high doses because they will promote the survival of the cancer cells that already exist in the body. There's different angles to the future work that can be taken. In terms of new therapies, yes, I think we should definitely start considering prooxidants, or at least considering therapies that will modulate antioxidant responses of the cancer cells, because we know that might be a weak spot for metastasizing cancer cells. So if we can target the pathways that allow cells to withstand oxidative stress, we have a higher chance of targeting residual disease, metastatic disease.